Hey everyone, and welcome to another Monday step-by-step tutorial where today we're going to learn how to find the locus of a point using parametric equation step-by-step. This was a comment from an earlier video, so make sure to stick to the end and enjoy. All right, let's not waste any more time. Just again, don't forget to subscribe, turn those bell notifications, and our question is find the locus of the midpoint of P, brackets 2AP, comma AP squared, and Q, 2AQ, AQ squared, given that PQ equals negative 1. So obviously these are the parametric points that lie on the parabola x squared equals 4AY. So what's step one in finding the equation of the locus? Well, find the coordinates of the point we want to find the locus of, which is the midpoint of PQ. Now I've made a whole other tutorial on how to find that point, so I won't go over that today. So let's just find the midpoint of PQ, which is really straightforward anyway. We just average the coordinates and we'll get A brackets P plus Q over 2 for the X coordinate, and A brackets P squared plus Q squared over 2 for the Y coordinate. So that's the coordinates of the midpoint of PQ. So what's step two? Well, we want to create parametric equations by letting x equal the x coordinate and y equal the y coordinate. So now we have x equals a brackets p plus q and y equals a on 2 brackets p squared plus q squared. Those are our parametric equations where we have to eliminate p and q to get a Cartesian equation just in terms of x and y. And the final step, step three, is eliminate all parameters to get the Cartesian equation using any special conditions to help. Now, a great tip here is first is to isolate the parameters on one side. So what that means will look like is for the x equation, p plus q equals x on a, and for the y equation, p squared plus q squared equals 2y on a. So we need to eliminate p and q, and our special condition in the question was pq equals minus 1. So now, in order to eliminate that, we need to find a link between p plus q and p squared plus q squared. So you have to think to yourself, what operation can turn p plus q into p squared plus q squared? You always want to go from the small to the high one. Going from high powers to low powers is usually harder. And it should be obvious is you have to square p plus q. Because if we square p plus q, we get p squared plus q squared plus 2pq. So then that means we just square the x equation. So that gives us x squared on a squared equals p squared plus q squared plus 2pq. And now we can sub in the condition that pq equals minus 1. So now that's x squared on a squared equals p squared plus q squared minus 2. And if we make p squared plus q squared the subject, that just equals x squared on a squared plus 2. So now we can just directly substitute that into the y equation and we get 2y on a equals x squared on a squared plus 2. And p and q are now gone. That is our Cartesian equation. All right guys, that's it for this tutorial, right? It's really straightforward finding locus of most points. There's only very few that are actually really hard, but most of the time it's pretty straightforward as you see with this three-step process. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to leave your thoughts below, smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on those bell notifications so you know when my awesome videos are released. I'll see you Wednesday.